Yo, what's going on, y'all? Chagat Perrier, and we are back with another video. Yo, this time we all got a special treat today. Y'all didn't know today was J. Cole Day.
I am not one of these niggas banging.
J. Cole.
Yeah.
Jermaine.
Yeah.
Cole.
Yes.
Nah, but his album just dropped, the off season. And we gotta go ahead and check this one out, y'all. You know, do a quick first impression slash reaction. Y'all know how we do, alright? So yeah, let's go. Alright, y'all, welcome back. Yo, like I said, J. Cole just dropped. So when J. Cole drops, we go ahead and we listen. Alright, we listen. Like I said, I want to go ahead and do a quick reaction slash impressions video for y'all. And yo, real quick, y'all, if this is your first time checking out my video, man, y'all know what y'all gotta do. Make sure you go ahead and like, make sure you go ahead and comment, make sure you go ahead and subscribe, and you gotta hit that bell, baby. But getting back into this, I gave it a proper listen. I probably listened to the album about 4.5 times over at this point. And got some doubts. Real quick, right off the bat, I wanna say that J. Cole came, he came with it for this album. J. Cole's been, you know, kinda out of the loop for a solid, 3 years now, since he dropped KOD. And I was missing some J. Cole. And actually, I tweeted before he announced a damn thing. I was just like, you know what? We need some J. Cole. We do. Check out the timestamp. I did that. So jumping right into the impressions, y'all. I think off the bat, the whole mindset and the whole theme I feel of this album was aggressive. Listening to every single track off of his album, all I felt throughout it was just bars, you know, wisdom, growth, but definitely aggression. This is a man that's matured, that, you know, is very family oriented, is very focused, and he ain't about that bullshit. He's on one, y'all. He is all one. So jumping straight into the first track. And I know if y'all some J. Cole fans out there as well, leave a like. It's probably one of your favorites too. 95 South. When CDs was around, when you sold out triple debt, I can't believe these fucking clowns. Look at everybody. I don't know how I slept on that the first time, but listen to that track. Crazy. Crazy. The Killer Cam sample on that. Crazy. That's one thing you're going to see throughout this actual album is that his lyrics and his bars, you gotta listen or you gonna miss some gems. And I feel like bar for bar on 95 South alone was crazy. I mean, he's straight clowning all whack rappers. If you're a whack rapper, you don't wanna listen to this track, all right? He's clowning all of y'all. He got lines like, sleep is the cousin of death and I don't plan to doze off. I mean, hard. And then my favorite bar, probably off of this entire album, It's yet to be determined, but right now, could put an M on your head, you Luigi brother now. Bars. I love the Killer Cam kind of the intro feature, the kind of spoken word type of vibe he had on the track. I thought it was real cool. I thought it was cool for him to jump on it and just kind of give that whole vibe and like really big up J. Cole. Next track on this album was Amari. And I felt like it was cool. It had some gems. Again, a lot of bars and a lot of metaphors on that particular track. I just can't remember all of them right now. My Life is actually another one of my favorite tracks on this album right now. And I felt like the production was cool. It was dope. But again, I felt like on this particular track, he had a lot of good storytelling in his lyrics. Great storytelling, great lyricism in general. And it just kind of painted all these little pictures in my head about, you know, where he's at in the hood, cops coming around, you know, XYZ. So definitely liked it, but I also really liked it because I think 21 Savage kind of showed out on that track. Vivid description in his lyrics, storytelling, you know, it was just good, you know, and I think that was one of his best verses in a while, if not his best verse. I mean, I love that verse.
Say what? The stuff that I seen got me traumatized. I let the K go when Johnny died.
100 mil. Again, show it out. And this showed out more of his confidence, I feel. And I feel like throughout the entire album, like I said before, you just got nothing but confidence and aggression. That's his whole motto on this album. I'm gonna have to read this one because this was just too crazy. Don't care if it's Michael B. Jordan that's calling my woman. The fuck she ain't gonna never pick up. What? Can y'all say the same thing about y'all girl? Can y'all say the same thing about your woman? He ain't playing. That's a hard bar right there. That's a hard bar right there.
Proud of my niggas, they never switched up. Don't care if it's Michael B. Jordan that's calling my woman. The fuck she ain't gonna never pick up. Sally.
Pride is in the devil. Another hard track. Another hard track, y'all. And this one is actually featuring Lil Baby. And I felt like Pride is in the Devil is probably one of the best productions on this album. I felt like the production was cool, but it's one of those productions that you gotta really just kind of chill on and kind of vibe out to and kind of give it a second chance, because it may not hit you that hard the first go around. I think he actually said something similar on one of these damn tracks. I don't know if it was applying the pressure or what. Probably forgetting right now. I don't remember.
Will I have anything or will I be destroyed?
Hey.
Terrified, paranoid, I put you over everything.
Hey, but real quick, y'all, I gotta go back to 95 South though. Hey. It's between 95 South and this other track. And this other track, Hunger on Hillside. Hunger on Hillside was, you know, I didn't expect to like it as much as I did, but I love the production. I love how J. Cole is coming on that track. I love the energy that he has on it. And again, nothing but bars and metaphors, and like literally everything that he's doing on that track is what he should be doing on that track.
We sold out in less than an hour. These words I still sing like I'm slept on.
Ooh.
I said so I can't cast the next stone.
Unless- love it, love it, love it, love it, love it, y'all. And again, the bars. I put my tongue up in my bitch, you get to hollering.
This nigga nasty.
This nigga's nasty. And the dude that's actually featured on this track was pretty good as well. I believe he goes by Bass or Bass, one of those two, but I liked him. He was definitely dope. I actually liked the other singer that he had on this album. His name was Murray. So Bass, Murray, they did their damn thing. I love them on the actual choruses and on the features. It was dope. Me being an R&B dude that I am, I appreciated them being on that freaking track. Shout out to y'all. So, to wrap things up, y'all, I think this is a solid album. Do I think this is his best album? Can't say that. Can't say that off of listening to this within 24 hours. I think it's a solid album. I think it's probably going to be one of the best, if not the best, rap album of the year. I think when he said all the stuff in his documentary about coming with this new energy, coming with this hunger, even though he's really at the top of his game, I believed it, and I believe he showed it here. The lyricism, y'all. The lyricism is on that level. I don't know if it's gonna top that. There's so many bars and lyrics and double entendres and stuff that he has throughout all of these tracks. It's insane. When I listened to 95 South again, it was crazy. It was bar after bar. He was just saying all this crazy shit. Just constantly. So listen. If y'all haven't listened to this album yet, y'all need to go ahead and listen to this. It's definitely cool. I already named my favorites. 95 South, Hunger on Hillside, My Life, Amari, Pride is in the Devil, 100 Mil, and there's a few others that I'm forgetting, but I think really listen to the album and giving it a chance and really listening to it like an album, not listening to it in a playlist, listening to the album holistically. He knocked it out the park. I thought it was dope. And I really appreciated the fact that I didn't like it at first, or I didn't like really have strong feelings for it at first, and it like grew on me in a major way. And that goes to show that he's really at the top of his game when it comes to that. So yeah, but listen, that's just my opinion, y'all. Y'all gotta let me know how y'all feel about that down below in the comment section. Let me know. Leave a like. Definitely appreciate y'all spending some time with me on this one. And listen. Thank y'all again, and I'ma see y'all on the next one. Peace.